gotta drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. That's why Dez is coming to town. He's making a shit, he's checking it twice. Gonna find out if it'll fly real nice. That's why Dez is coming to town. He sees you when you're streaming. He knows if you make mistakes. He knows if your language is bad or good. So be good for the community's sake. So, you better install a Kerbal Engineer. Better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das war Dez is coming to town. He knows if you use MacJab. He knows if you have fins. He spends 4 hours on fashion lights just to crash it in the end. So, you better install a Kerbal Engineer. You better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das war Dez is coming. Das war Dez is coming. Das war Dez is coming to town.
Ah, yes. Why is that there? Where is it? That's my desktop in the background. I guess that's okay. Who cares if that's there? Is that right? Do I hear it? I do hear it. Why is it so quiet? Why are you so quiet? Come on. One of these days. Mixer? That's okay. Is that volume okay? Let me know if the volume's okay there. Let me know if the volume's okay. Turn that off. There we go. That monitor capture. I've got to fix that monitor capture thing. It makes me very, very, very much unsynced with the rest of the things. Am I live? Can y'all see me? Tell me if you can see me. I am doing good, people. I am doing quite fine. I don't know why the chiptune sounds so quiet. Maybe I just need to turn them up. Yeah, there we go. Ah, yes. Mystified Mustard, what's shaking? Welcome. Is everything okay? Yeah, everything's fine, it looks like. Everything's fine. You have a question? Ah, yes, I am live. Volume's fine. Excellent. Guys, thanks for the help. Thank you for the help. Astro Coop with the host, the first host of the evening. I appreciate it. Zenik, what's going on? Herodas. Imbu enjoying da-da-da-da. Sweet Dragon enjoying the streams all week. Excellent. Tanner and I am live. Thank you. Thank you. Noda, I can of course help you with the mission. I think I've got a couple things I'm going to do first, and I am going to definitely be helping out people. I'm going to do a head sync. Chiptunes. I shouldn't be desynced anymore. Me. No, it doesn't look like I'm desynced anymore. It's just whenever I have the desktop capture going. What's up, J-Dude? Qwerty Bro, what's up? Undead Beast Guy, hello. How's it going? Perfect timing, Porter John. I agree. This is good timing. What are we doing tonight? We're going to be doing some help desk. I think I need to do some rescue missions. I'm going to be focusing on rendezvous and docking operations. I think we're going to do some space plane docking and rendezvous. And we're going to use that station that we were working on last night. Some more toast to you. Das! What happened to TeamSpeak? I haven't been in TeamSpeak lately. Vader, I need to get in TeamSpeak at some point. Maybe we could get some TeamSpeaks. Are we going to Duna tonight? No, Duna is tomorrow or the next day. I think I'm doing shuttles tomorrow, and I'll do Duna the next day. Wait, I've already gone to Duna in my hard mode career. It may be Jewel or something. It may be Jewel or Eve or something we do next. But that's going to be next week. Tonight's just straight up help desk. We'll be answering more questions. I'm desynced. Okay, I think I fixed that. There's Zenik. Oh, this is scrolled up. There you go. I'm just making sure I got everything. Yes, Tenorin, I was about to go on air. All bad, what's up? Optic Baka. Hello, hello. You require additional cash. T-Game, sorry about that. Caboose. What's shaking? Caboose, Pathadre here. Looks like we got Pathadre Salam. Dude, I saw you streaming some KSP as I was, like, crashing out last night. Pathadre, how did it go? Zenik's doing good. About to watch anime. But then I came up. Can you do landings when you do space planes? Sure, of course I'll do that. Evening, Mr. Kabe, Jebediah Dickerman. Writings here, Kamuchi with the Psylove. Nice. Das, perfect timing for my insomnia. Vic Chess. How's it going, Vic Chess? You just did a door stream. What is a door stream? I don't understand what a door stream is. You were streaming your door? Zaldifax! Welcome back, Zaldifax. How's it going? Happy Festivus. Dude, Zaldifax, thank you again, man. Thank you again. He did. You saw it. What was door? I don't understand what door is. What does that mean? Have a trainer built with South Strike, the Illustrator, etc. We've got one of those two Crown True Silver. I've got one up on Kerbal X. I think I may build it from scratch right quick, though. I think we need something that has a docking thing. But count you silver, dude. Welcome. Link it up right quick. Dude, man, let me have a look at it. Maybe I can use it. Pathadre did pretty well. Have a beta career-related question, though. I haven't opened the help desk yet. I will in just a second. Thanks a lot. You could raise the help desk. Oh, Zenik. No worries. Do you have your Moon Rover lifter saved so I could look at it for a couple seconds? Yes. The Commandant Lee is definitely, Oh, he docked. A docking and rendezvous. I see what you're saying. He docked and rendezvous. That's what it was. D-A-R, I think. Jacob Orth, what's going on? You have witnesses that you docked successfully. I believe you. I just talked to you on the phone, dude. What do you mean? Yes. Let's see here. The Commandant Lee. Can somebody get the link to the Commandant Lee? Mike, what's up? To the Commandant Lee that's on Kerbal X. Looks like some people were looking for it there. Porter John was looking for it there. The Moon Rover, the Commandant Lee should be up there. Door equals ProSpeak. Gonna try and do a moon landing in return on the demo. How do you SSTO from Duna? Mike, not the best place for SSTOs. You got the wings, but you have to use rocket fuel. It's almost more efficient to just go straight up in a rocket than it is to do an SSTO on Duna. Can you show us a plane docking? Absolutely, Diamond. Absolutely. Rabbit Duck, start your career mode pre-beta. Do I have to start a new career mode to get the new stuff? Rabbit Duck, I believe so. How to rendezvous without nodes. Oh, snap. I think I'm going to start with that. See how your lifter was designed. Wasn't it, I think it should be on the craft thing. I think the lifter version of it should be over there like that. Which mic? All the mics. Hello to all the mics. folks, let's actually get started playing some games here. I've got 4 minutes to get the game started, or I'm late, so let me do that. Click, click. Can y'all hear that clicking? I bet you can hear the clicking. Shurikreen, what's going on? If you don't have to stage, then you have SSTO'd. Duna, I mean, the typical SSTO is a plane, right, that uses an air-breathing engine to get a lot of altitude and speed to go into orbit. Duna is not a great place for that, having not enough oxygen content in the atmosphere. It's not a great idea to try and do an SSTO plane on Duna, because you've got to have rocket engines, and the longer you take with your rocket engines flying through the atmosphere, you're burning oxidizer you're carrying with you. You know what I mean? Drink 3 Honor Palmers. Oh, come on, don't do that. Don't do that. I'm not going to... I've learned a long time. Eve. PB&J. There's Nubia. There's the Lee. Is that the Lee plus the lifter, I wonder? I really need screenshots. Folks, I'll give 10 points of extra credit to anybody who downloads one of my Kerbal X craft and sends me a screenshot of it in action so that I can update it to Kerbal X. I'll give you props on Kerbal X for providing the screenshot. I really do appreciate it, but I'll give extra credit to anybody who can help me out with that. That's a nice looking screenshot right there. That is a nice looking screenshot. If I had the game open, which I need to be doing, I would totally do that. So let's open up the game. Yeah, I need to shave. You know what I really need is a haircut. You see this back here? That's annoying. Can you see it? You can actually see the green screen messing up. Yeah, there you go. You can see the green screen. You use credits for raffles, Mike. If you want to, load up your KSP to play along. I'm going to be doing some help desk. I think I'm going to do a mission or two, and then I'm going to be doing some help desk. Can anybody else not hear him? Flame, that's probably just you. Wait, you can't hear me. Why am I talking to you? You need to do the thing, Flame. Somebody tell Flame to just refresh. Can you send a screenshot? Absolutely. You may want to hang on to it. Let me open up the help desk in a minute. You may want to hang on to it, Noda, for just a second. I think I'm going to do one of the rescue missions with no nodes right quick and show you how to do it. Show you how to accomplish it with no nodes. I think I'm going to go into my hard mode career and do that rescue mission right quick. So let's start with that, and then I will open up the help desk. I'll open up the help desk. Is my channel title okay, by the way? I saw that Trump was streaming, and he said that he was docking badly, so I started up mine and said, learn to dock less badly. Is that okay with anybody? I hope that should be okay. yes. Shin is still going. I'm very happy that Shin and Trump are streaming. Shimmy is still doing stock shuttle and spaceship building. I was watching Shimmy earlier as well with his awesome chair. Texans! 45. I'm going to be doing a rescue mission. We need to update this here. Why with an open KSP a place? Oh, I would love the RPN calculator. I would love the RPN calculator. We are going to be doing docking. We're going to be doing rendezvous. I'm going to do a rescue here. We're going to focus on some of the more basic orbital operations. Drew Gamer, here you go. An up-to-date Delta V map. Our cheat. You spent 3 hours on TeamSpeak helping him out, Sarian? Nice. Heck yeah. Thank you for doing that. 3 hours on TeamSpeak with Shin. How do you pronounce that? Shinrer? Heck yeah. Mike, we're probably not doing raffles today. I love this song. I'm going to turn it up. And we are going to start. I'm going to go do a rescue. Ooh. How loud is that to y'all? Let me know while at work, too. Spartan! Bot activating. Post it up, Zelda. Basical orbital operations. That's probably what I said. Let's play the game. Beta or not, here we come. Sarian, thanks for helping other people out. Anybody got Cordoba? Nice, there we go. Music is the perfect volume. Alright. Okay, good. We need a rescue contract. Let's do it. Says German Kerman, or whatever this dude's name is. Plant a flag on Minimus. Science data. We'll take that one all day long. Plant a flag on Duna. I could do that. God damn it, Nora. Let's play some video games. What? Like your voice. Something out of buttery jazz-like voice. What? Heliosynchronous orbit of the sun? What? I have never seen that one before. I'm going to ditch some of these and see if I can't get a rescue mission. Basic jet engine splashdown for 20 science? Nah. Visual surveys of Duna? Nah. 187,000 though, especially if we're going on visual surveys. He is KSP's microscreen man. Oh yeah, full screen. I guess I should do that, huh? There you go. That's better. Thank you for reminding me. Plant a flag. That's going to be a longer one, but we can totally do it. Visual surveys of Duna? I've never done a visual survey contract. What do you have to do? Take an EVA report on the surface of Duna near a sector. Take a crew report in flight below 12,000 meters near a different zone. I think I'm going to do it. I think I'm going to accept that contract. I want to do an orbital rescue, though. Ah, that one. Man, I don't want that one to go away. What else do we have? Science data from Minmus. Science data from the moon. Science data from Kerbin. Okay, we can knock out a bunch of science datas right quick. Landed at Minmus. We would need to do a thing right quick as well. Jeez. There's a satellite in an equatorial orbit of Duna. Explore Eve. Explore Gilly. That's probably what we're going to know next week. Visual surveys of Eve. Let me toss that one off. Uh-huh. Okay, wow, 362,000 though. Temperature scans of Minmus. Oh, Minmus would be such an easy place to do temperature scans. It really would. Yeah, I know about the zones. Here is Brain Fried. Let me look at this. You docked times two, man. You got a little space station going and everything. Let's see here. Copy image URL. I don't actually have the Iron Horse 54, dude. Long time no see, man. How you doing? How are you doing, Iron Horse? Thank you for the follow. Are you on the Xbox? You're on the Xbox right now, probably, huh? I bet you are. Let me bring up Brain Fried's successful docking mission here. Bring Brain Fried. Wait a second. That's not the image I was looking at. Good thing it wasn't something else. There we go. This is the image. I must have clicked on the image. All right. Let me bring up this one. Oh, yeah. Clear. Cybertech put clear in there for me. Thank you, Cybertech. There you go. You got the double dock there. Pro Combat. What's shaking? Damascus here as well. That's your first one. Look at this. You got two craft docked. You got enough RCS? I hope I hope with that much RCS, 750 units of RCS, I hope you were able to get docked with that much RCS. Because that's a lot. Well done, though, Brain Fried. Well done. You told Trump to come and ask you for help on an orbital rescue mission. I'm actually looking for an orbital rescue mission right now. I could totally knock out the space above... Kerbin, because we've got this guy. This guy was launched very early on in the career, and he has more than done his time up here in the station. When he runs out of electric charge, he's going to be done. His useful lifespan is going to be done, but he is just our little orbital science station right now. Look, Gillong here. Gillong just gets to do a crew report. Watch what I'm doing here. If you're in career mode and you want to insulate your career from ever failing, put a satellite like this into orbit. It doesn't even have to have a Kerbin on it. You could have a Kerbal and like a Gravioli or something like that. You don't need that, but the Kerbal, are we there yet? That's his crew report. What? Put a Kerbal in a pod. It would be good if he had some sort of power generation, which this guy doesn't have. He was launched before we had power generative capabilities. But put a Kerbal in a pod with an antenna on it, do a crew report, you get a contract that looks like this, transmit or recover scientific data from the space around Kerbin, and watch. This guy can just sit in orbit forever. And he can transmit that empty science, the empty crew report home, just asking if he's there yet. Watch what happens. Transmitter to recover. There goes that. It's going to use some of my electric charge. And then bam, transmitter recover. What did I get from this craft that's been sitting in orbit forever? 18 kerbucks. 18,000 kerbucks. So I cannot argue with that at all. I really cannot argue with that. You can insulate any career against ever failing by putting satellites around the typical orbital bodies with a way to transmit data, a Kerbal or some sort of scientific instrument that can be done, like a temperature scan wouldn't work from right here, right? You'd have to have a Gravioli meter or something like that. Or Kerbal's the best bet, because you get that very, 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 very often. You can take crew reports without Kerbals. Really? Wait, no you can't. Hang on, you can take a crew report without Kerbals? It says not enough crew. I can't do a crew report without a Kerbal. I don't think you can take crew reports without Kerbals. I think you've got to have the Kerbal in there. It says not enough crew. But that right there, I can complete an infinite number of those contracts and my career will never fail. It doesn't matter what happens in my career. As long as I've got guys on station around the primary orbital bodies. Michi, what's going on? I can always dig my career back out. If it was a probe... DOS, a probe would be good as well. Oh, if there was a probe on it, maybe. If you have a probe core, a Stay Putnik, you can do crew reports even if there's not a Kerbal in there. Interesting. I launched this long before I had any of that stuff. I launched this like very early in the mission so I could spam those orbital stuff. Cash. Ah, very cool. There was a follow. Guys, I'm going to try to be better about the follows today. Mr. Gators, thanks for the follow. I appreciate you. Also looks like Raphael PK was in there. Firefitter, Ozzy M. Guys, I appreciate the follows. Welcome to Kerbal Help Desk. I'm doing some things right now. We're just doing kind of basic... I'm doing basic orbital procedures here. Wow, that's loud. There you go. Let's turn that down a little bit. All right. There was Firefitter's follow. We farmed that contract. We could also... That was 18K, so your career can never fail once you get those situations... What am I looking for? Those assets in place. Let's go back to the Space Center, see what else we've got to do. War Prodigy, what's shaking? Turn that into a KSS, a Kerbal Science Station. I will get a bigger science up there. A bigger station would be good. I'm for Arkan Zebra. What? I've got over 1 million kerbucks in this save now. 1,600,000, it looks like. This is my ultra hardcore career. You can't hear the chiptunes? Can anybody else hear the chiptunes? Let me know if that's going away. A newbie cheese lover. Start with the demo. How do you recommend? Come to one of my boot camps. I can't accept more than new contracts. Rabid Duck, upgrade your mission control, Rabid. If you come out here, look, this is help desk, so I'm going to try and be getting these questions as fast as I can. excuse me. if you right click on this building and if you upgrade it, it's not going to cost you 400. It's going to cost you like 64 or something like that. You can barely hear them? Really? Is that better? Tell me. Your volume is maxed. How is the music? They're extremely quiet. Did I just fix it? As of right now, did I just fix it? Let me know. If you upgrade this building, your mission control, you'll go from 2 to 7 active contracts. 2 to 7. And look, if I upgrade it again, I'll be able to go to unlimited active contracts. So you're going to have to, if you're in career, update your mission control station, your mission control building, so you can handle more contracts. I wanted to rescue somebody. Visual surveys of the moon. Test a mainsail landed at Duna. What? Test a mainsail landed at Duna. All right, test a mainsail landed at Duna. Drunk Corner, that video is actually up there. There's Minimus. There's a video called Minimus Landing Drills, and in that I build the KSA Double Canoe, which is the landing craft, the carrier to take the landers to Duna. It is the landing drills on Duna is what I called it. I almost want to orbiting Minimus. No, I want an extra temperature scans of Minimus. Equatorial orbit of Duna. Parachute in flight. I don't care. I want a rescue mission. Visual surveys of Minimus. Test this landed at Kerbin for 16 science. Jeez, that would be easy. I almost want to do this one. Plant a flag on Minimus. I'm not getting any rescue missions. I really want a rescue mission here. Let's do a very quick, let's do a very quick Minimus mission. We need to put a science data for Minimus. Liquid fuel landed at Minimus. Let's grab all the Minimus contracts right quick. Plant a flag on Minimus. Let's knock out these Minimus things right quick. Temperature scans of Minimus. That's a lot of temperature scans to have to do. That's actually going to take a long time. I don't want to do that right now. Here's one that has 4 temperature scans. I don't really want to do that either. LV-1 liquid fuel engine orbiting Minimus. Okay, we can do that. We're going to do a bunch of Minimus things here. We're going to do a bunch of Minimus things. I'd love to see it, O-Codes. Post it up. Post it up. I've got a stack of Minimus' missions. Let's go to Minimus really quickly. Let's toss these missions out. And I'm going to be answering... I'm going to try to be answering questions as I do this. And I'm trying to knock out contracts so I can get a rescue contract. I really want a rescue contract because that's what I want to do. We're going to Minimus. We have to have a Minimus lander. How much cash do we have? 170,000. You know what we're going to do right now, folks? We are going to... I'm looking at your Zocodes. That is an awesome craft! I love that craft! Oh my gosh, hang on a second. That thing looks amazing. I love the use of the the space plane parts for things other than space planes. In that right there, looks really freaking awesome. That really does look awesome. Good job. I don't know where you got those landing legs, but good job. I really, really, really do like that craft design, man. Well done. O-Codes, well done. I love it. That is very nice. Thank you for sharing that with me. I appreciate it. What is the real world equal to Minimus? There's not really a real world equal to Minimus. It's just a tiny... It's almost like a captured comet or asteroid that's in a Kerbin orbit. So that would be some sort of captured comet or asteroid in Earth orbit, which we don't have that we know of unless the aliens are shielding us from us. Who knows? But, all right. Let's see. What were we going to do? Let me write down my contracts and let me make sure that I've got this done. I'm trying to get a rescue contract. Visual surveys of Duna. Plant a flag on Minimus. Okay, let me open up my notepad. Let me do this. Oh, I'll leave that up for you. Whatever. We'll do this here. So we need to plant a flag. Plant flag. This is going to be the Minimus mission. We need to plant a flag. We need to get science data from, what is it? From orbit on Minimus. We need to test LV-1 in orbit of Minimus. Test LV-1 in orbit, and then test LV, what was that? LV-1R landed at Minimus. Okay, test LV-1R landed at Minimus like that. Alrighty, that looks good. Heck yeah, wait a second. No. Hey, there you go. No, go, stop. Okay. Well, let's just keep that one out. Dude, Reaper Moran, thank you for stopping by. I appreciate you. What's up, Commando Solo? Do a speed run to Minmus to do that contract. Cool Cat, what's shaking? Don't go all Eric's alien conspiracy. Nice. Landing legs are carbonite. Thank you. No real world equivalent. I'm going to be trying to answer questions, guys. I'm doing a help desk and I'm doing some missions. Oh, Codes, that was an awesome Minmus lander. I really did like it. Cap Sierra, I hope your day's doing okay. It's quieter than usual? I don't understand why the chiptunes would be quieter than usual. They're actually turned way up from what they usually are, which is interesting. Are they good now? Are they good now? Tell me. I just cranked the volume up even more. Tell me if this is good. Tell me if that's good. Is that too loud or not? That is an awesome reentry feature, DeGrozovich. That is awesome. You drove to Taco Bell, got food and a large Dr. Pepper. I want to watch some DOS. Heck yeah. All right. So we're also going to leave a probe. We're going to install a base at Minmus, I think. We are going to install a permanent base at Minmus. We need to test these things. Oh, those are the things we've got to test. That's cool. All right. What base sort of parts do I have? And if we're installing too loud. Okay, this is too loud now. All right, thanks, guys. So I'm going to split the difference between the changes I made. Okay, that is splitting the difference. Some people say too loud, some people don't. I think this should be good. Thanks, guys. I appreciate the help. I do appreciate the help. It's pretty good. Turn it down a bit on your end. Okay. All right. I think before I do the Minmus mission, where would you build it? Kerbin, the Moon, or Minmus? I would do it in low Kerbin orbit, honestly. This is a base, just really a lander not intended to take off. Oh, it's just going to be a simple base. It's going to be a simple Minmus science sort of base, okay? That's all it's going to be. I do believe... Remember, right now, in my career, I needed to upgrade this building because I'm limited to spending... I've got 2178 science in the bank from my other missions, and I cannot research any more technologies because I've got to upgrade the science, the research center. I didn't upgrade the research center because it was going to cost me a million kerbucks. I didn't have the money at the time. Now I've got 1.7 million kerbucks, and I think what I'm going to do is go ahead and upgrade this. I think I am going to go ahead and upgrade this right now. Cha-ching! We just spent a million kerbucks upgrading the Science Center, but now I can go into the Science Center and I can unlock more awesome stuff. Large landing legs, I don't really need to do that for now, I guess. Ah, the press map barometer, that would be good. Let's get that for 160 science. This is going to be advanced electrics. Excellent. Solar panels that deploy. That is excellent. With the Space Engineer server, Kithacore, I've kind of stepped away from that for a minute. I'm focused on this until after Christmas. Thank you for asking, though. Advanced electrics are going to be huge. Ah, probe-sized parts. Probes are going to be huge for us. Advanced, okay, prop tanks. Yeah, there's the Mark 1 lander can. I definitely want that for Minmus. Advanced space plane parts I'm not going to worry about right now. The Claw. I've got a lot of space junk, and I've been waiting to get the Claw, and I need to get the Claw. That's awesome. Here is, okay. There's the Hitchhikers plus some docking ports. We've got to have those. And this is going to be larger rocket parts, including the mainsail and that huge KR-1X2. Heck yeah. What else can I research? I'm just knocking things out of the park here. Look at this. There's command chairs and rover wheels. That would be cool. The seismic accelerator. Let's take that to Minmus. That's going to cost me 300. I've basically got two more things. More advanced electrics. I don't really need those right now. Ion probe parts wouldn't be too bad. There is a miniature probe core. I really do think that I'm going to go for that miniature probe core. I really do like that miniature probe core. Here's advanced stabilization. Oh, that has the cupola in it. The cupola in the Mark II lander can. I think I'm going to put a cupola on my Minmus base. So I'll unlock that for now. Advanced those, I'm not worried about. more space plane parts with those. I'm not worried about those right now in my career save. Ooh, the cubic octostrut. Here is advanced construction. That has the Clampatron Jr. I don't think I'm going to worry about that for now. The nuclear engine? The nuclear engine? I'm not going to do it for now. I'm going to save this science in the bank for future missions. I've got to unlock these parts. Those big heavy lander legs, those may be actually useful for my Minmus. We don't need those on Minmus. Yeah, let's just stick it for now. We're just going to stick it for now, and we'll buy parts from the VAB as we need it. How the ion engines work. The ion engines burn xenon gas. They get insane ISP. They get 4,200 ISP. This is okay for me to do, right? They get insane ISP. The nuclear engine gets 800 ISP in vacuum. The ion engines get 4,200 ISP. But they're very, very, very low thrust. I got a drink, by the way. They're very low thrust. So let's go over here. Let's put this Minmus base together right quick. We're going to keep it pretty simple here. We are going to keep it pretty simple here for the Minmus base. Folks, welcome to Kerbal Help Desk. I'm trying to answer questions. Oh, Help Desk begins. We got to upgrade that. Let's see here. Let me do a add command. He just blessed the entire chat. I did? Oh, I did? Yes. Chat. Oh, my gosh. Just a backwards peace sign. Okay, thank you, Ridecar. I appreciate that. All right. SE. I don't, Cap Sierra. I don't actually do that yet. I don't know anything about it. I really don't. The mission, so let me do an edit com mission. It's going to be help desk with some hard mode missions. Like that. Help desk with some hard... Okay. There you go. All right, I'll take that one. Gav, I'll take your edit. There you go. We'll do it. I need to design this base right quick. I was just going to keep it really simple, but there's not really a reason to at this point in my career. I am just going to have... That's the Dr. Pepper alarm clock. Yes, it is the Dr. Pepper alarm clock. Let's see what we can do here. I want my root node to be the science lab. And I need to unlock that for 10K. I've got to watch my money here. I don't want to run out of money. So there's the science lab for 10K. And there is that. I really need my own flag in here, honestly. Did I ever install my own flag? I did. Or here's the Kerbal Space Academy flag. There you go. Well, actually, I like mine better. Because it's got the view through. There you go. It just kind of paints it on there. Mike, I forget to drink. I talk so much, I forget to drink. So that's why that's on there. So we've got that. We don't really need a thermometer on here, but how much does a thermometer cost? It's actually pretty expensive. 900. Oh, whatever. We're not poor. Let's put it on there. Everybody likes to know what the time is. So we've got that on. Now I just need to make this capable of transferring and landing itself on Minmus. What's the res for the flags? What does that mean? What is the resolution for the flags? I would have to look that up. Fezzi's got it. 256 by 160. 256 by 160. When I take a contract to put a probe in a specific orbit, does it have to be orbiting in the same direction? Yes, it does. It does have to be in the same direction. Pro Combat. For now, I'm not going to do it during stream. If you remind me off stream, I can totally give you a copy of it. But for now, I think I'm just going to stick with it. Actually, the KSA flag. Wait. Pro Combat. The KSA flag is in... let's see here. It's in the homework. It's in the homework file. Pro Combat. The KSA flag right there is in the homework file. So, I'm making a Minmus science lander. Let's see what we can do here. Can I put this in 4X symmetry? You'll see what I'm doing. I'm just kind of putting a base on Minmus. Yep, got it. Bam! Wah, 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 wah! There you go. If you're ever in Vegas, lunch or dinner is on me. Heck yeah. Did I say everybody likes to know the time? On a planet, you would be able to tell the time by the temperature. If it's really cold, it's probably night. And if it's really hot, you're probably in direct sunlight. You know what's hilarious about Minmus? I bet you I can land with these. Yes. I could definitely land this on Minmus with these. All day, every day. When do we turn in the homework? Aperture Science, whenever you want. All you have to do is put an Imgur, upload it to Imgur somewhere and post the screenshot in here. Post a screenshot in here. Did I miss a follow? I apologize for that. Tien Tiger 12. Thanks for the follow. I appreciate you. Comet God, Quirster, Undead, Psycho, Astronaut. That doesn't sound good unless you're driving on your own and you don't have a burst or dramjet, because you can kill people with those things. Cheese Lover, Shadow Kitty, Octorus. Thanks for the follows, guys. Why is my little ringly-dingly thing not going off? Are they popping up on the screen? Tell me if the followers are popping up on the screens. Wait, what's this about homework? I gave some homework yesterday, and if you complete the homework, they are. It is overkill for Minmus. It is overkill for Minmus. We could probably do it with two, but I'm just going to leave it like this. If you were here for Kerbal Help Desk or for Kerbal Space Academy last night, I gave some homework. If you complete the homework, you can earn yourself 25 extra credits. 25 extra credits you can use for entering into raffles and stuff like that that I like to do. So welcome to my stream. The homework link will get you the homework. I don't have Clampatron Senior docking ports yet. That's lame. Okay, the sound is going to. All right, good deal. Thank you, thank you. All the follows, Jiffus, Hank, French Toast, Ghostly Hawk, Claymore57, Quester. Thanks for the follows, guys. I appreciate you. It's a stream where Twitch is. Yes, I am. Boot camp? Wait, boot camp? It's a team. Yeah, it's a stream where I tell you how to play. I actually have them uploaded to YouTube. Anyone else like pickles? Pickles are delicious. I do not disagree with a love of pickles there. I'm going to put those like that. That's looking good. I really wanted this thing to dock. I really did want this thing to dock. Everybody knows we've got to unlock this docking port. And I wanted it to dock with an orbital station. But I guess we don't really need that, huh? I'll just put a docking port on the bottom for now. That's looking good. It burned you out on homework. Ah, folks, that was a nice craft to fly. Aperture Science. Well done! Aperture Science. Guys, I don't know if I can bring all these up on the screen. I usually try to bring all my homework up on the screen, but I don't know if I'll be able to get them all. I do apologize if I can't get yours, but Aperture! Bootcamp 1220, Aperture Science! Landing the Mooner Trainer Mark III on the moon. Congratulations, and you completed the contract. One of my mods is going to make sure that you get that out there. Thank you. One of my mods is going to make sure. Guys, thank you for doing the homework. It's really cool. That's a pretty well-designed craft, if I do say so myself. Let me keep building this Minimus science base. I've got that. I'm going to put a cupola on it. I did say that I would put a cupola. Everybody loves the view from a cupola. 10,000 to unlock. We ain't poor. Let's unlock it. There's the cupola. It's a little tall, honestly. Excuse me, guys, for my voice. I've got to work this out of this. I think that this is, let's see here. Yeah, there you go. All right. I think that's good. I really wanted a way for the lander probe to land on it. Well, I don't have any fuel here. Do you use the Werner engine? I do sometimes. This is hard mode career right now, Russ. Rufus. Rufus RK, actually. This is hard mode career. Gosh, I really wanted some way for this guy to land. All right. We can let him land. Watch. We can totally let him land. I'll do this. I'll do it this way. We'll fashion it up a bit. I'm going to need a little bit. What part do I use? Do I have that advanced construction part? I don't yet. That's actually kind of lame that I don't have it. Where's the center of mass? Fred, I think since the triangles go above, see how wide that triangle is? I think we'll be okay, but I will check it for you. The center of mass is nice and low. It'll be a little bit higher with the fuel gun, but I think we're okay. I think we're okay. You need a new PC. Gotcha. What's the mission? There you go. Ask me some questions, guys. Ask me some questions. Actually, we do need to... Ha! Ha! Gav! I win! Oh, no, 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 no. I can't type. Yes! All right. I need a place for the lander to land. And actually, I do think... There is videos. There are uploaded to YouTube, Ukamaka. There are some. There are some missions. Have you one poor Kerbal right all the way in the science can? I think I'm gonna take two or three or something like that. Game for fun. Wait, I'm having fun. Are you not having fun? I don't know what we're talking about there, but oh, I need to test these. I do need to test these. They're so inefficient. How do we land back at the KSC? Wow, there's so many questions, guys. Let's keep going. I'm gonna keep building this thing. I know I'm not reading. I'm not going to be reading chat. I'm telling you right now, I'm not gonna read chat for just a mission, just a minute. Got KSP last night. Been playing career all day, mixing in some sandbox to test builds. Made a flag design. It is really fun, Spaceman, and it fits your name. It fits your name. Lurg, how do you land back at this KSC? I'll try to do that for y'all. I'll try to do that for you. I did, Junks. That is what I did. Let me focus. Let me focus on this. Look. Let me edit com mission. And I'm going to say, just one second. Let's see what I've got here. Edit com mission, hard mode, career missions with KSA help desk seasoning. Seasoning. Hard mode career missions with KSA help desk seasoning. There we go. That's going to be the mission. Hard mode career missions with KSA help desk seasoning. So guys, I was trying to design something here. I'm getting a little distracted with the chat, so apologize. I do apologize. Let me see if I can't do this here. I wish there was some way I could refuel that guy. I wish I had some sort of fuel, but I want the science lab so I can clean his experiments. I've got to find some way for my lander to actually land and dock with this guy. And I think what we're going to do is this right here. Let's see if we can do this. Can I just put this on with 1x symmetry? Oh, I could put it on the side, I guess. In 2x symmetry, that'll make it be more balanced. And I could totally... This is a little dangerous, honestly. And it'll block out the cupola a little bit, I guess? I don't know. I think we're also going to need some SAS units on here. So let's make sure we've got SAS units. This is going to help us. I mean, we've got the pod SAS. That's really way too much SAS. Let's put it down here or up here or something. All right, that's better. That's better. I'm not planning on returning to orbit. Guys, watch the language, please. Watch the language in my stream. I just want some way for the lander to be able to land with it. Can't interact with the space center. I haven't run to that. I have not run into that. I'm trying to do a lot of things at once here, guys. Alright. I was going for something like this. Oh, that would work. Would that work? Or should I use this? I think I'm actually gonna go with that one. Hashtag seems legit. Let's see here. That's hilarious. That should allow the landers to land. That should definitely allow the landers to land, right? Things are doing great today, guys. Things are doing great today. I'm trying to make some way for the landers to land, and it looks like I could actually bring this down a bit. And then I could use the tweakable. Yeah, here we go. I'm gonna use the offset tool to bring them off the sides a little bit. Because I want my landers to be landing on them, right? I'm going to take a lander with me, and it's going to land there, but you can't, you're not allowed to cover up the cupola. So that should be a safe place for the landers to land, I think. I think this should be a safe place for the landers to land. Let's see here. Dostis, is that like going, I don't know, probably. Yes, that is a little bit going like that. I wish I didn't have to use those things. Do I have parts that I cannot have to use those things? I don't, unfortunately, unless I use fuel tanks. Unless I use fuel tanks. That's okay. We're just gonna leave it like that. We'll just leave it like that. It'll be okay. It'll be okay. This will be fine. Teflon Mike, what's shaking? How's it going? A recipe for disaster, but it looks cool. Why would this be a recipe for disaster? Wow, guys, so many questions coming in. I am gonna try to get to your questions. But I am also building this Minmus mission. But I will, I promise you, I will try to get to your questions. You're just going to have to be patient with me. I do appreciate everybody coming and hanging out with me. All right, see, that looks totally cool. How is that a recipe for disaster? It looks amazing. Look at this, just for, I don't think that is landers fitting inside a fairing. I'm not worried about fairings here. I will build the lander on top of this. Yeah. Does he not know how to dock? I really don't know how to dock. I have no clue how to dock. I'm not very good at docking. Ah, yes. I'm not very good at docking. I don't know what to tell you. I apologize. Teflon Mike, what's shaking? Land on the docking port with a lander. Oh, no, this will be easy. This is actually really easy to do. Watch. Watch. I'm going to build the lander right quick. Maybe, look, wait, I was going to do some fashion. So look, I'm just going to do a little bit of fashion here, and we're going to put a fuel line going from, like, the science lab up to there. That serves no purpose other than fashion, guys. It's really just a fashion thing. Let me toss together the lander on here. You can put them on the sides of this and the landers. It'd be really tricky to dock. No, we're good. We're good. Killer, thank you. Time-lapse assembly. I'll bring it up, but I can't look at it right now. Strut the bottom just for fashion, maybe? There you go. I'll pause that. And let me get this lander designed. I've got a specific lander design that I love to use for Minmus. It goes a little something like this. That would be good. Then I usually put guys with the follows, Deathly, D-Dan, YOLO Clash of Clans, Fathix, Orange Flamey Phoenix, UG Maverick, Star Killers, Lord Vader. Who else do we have? Cinermatic, Jiffus Hank. Guys, I appreciate y'all hanging out with me here. Excuse me. Ah, yes. I could go further. I'm gonna go bring the lander into a different craft. I can definitely land that. I really only have two docking ports there for balance purposes. That should be okay. Somebody wanted me to strut the bottom, and then I'll go design the lander. This is just for fashion as well. This is really only for fashion. That is really only for fashion. It really doesn't need to be there. It's just for fashion. Crispy, what's going on? This is going to be the Minmus Science Station. There we go. The follows, guys. Wicked Kiddo, that guy. Surprise, I'm here now. Thanks for the follows. Let me go and build. I've got the Minmus Science Station. Oops, I actually meant to name it the KSA Minmus Science Station. Save it. Let's go design a lander that can do all sorts of stuff. On Minmus, I love to use the Mark 1 lander can. If you're designing a low-gravity lander, the Mark 1 lander can is a great thing to use. It really is a great thing to use. Let me put my flag on it. It's light, right? If your difference is between this command pod Mark 1, look at that. 0.84 on the mass, whereas this guy here has 0.66. That's actually a 25% reduction in weight from the command Mark Part 1. So if you're building a low-gravity lander, this thing is a great thing to use if you don't have command chairs yet. We've got that. Did I unlock... I thought I unlocked a little... Interesting. Prograde retrograde hold, really? Oh, it's got prograde retrograde hold. That's actually really cool. Point some lights pointing towards... I'm going to put the lights on here. Don't forget to drink that Dr. Pepper. So I've got this. I'll put some fuel tanks on it. I know from experience that that right there should be a big enough fuel tank. I am definitely going to put a little bit of science on it. And I do believe, we're going to look at this, but I believe I should be able to carry two Science Juniors. The clipping on the Science Juniors is not great, but two Science Juniors right there looks okay to me. This is overkill, but you'll see why I do it. I'm going to put that docking port there, and I am definitely going to put two. This is such overkill. I'm going to put two of these little OP engines. You just don't need that thrust to weight. You really don't. But the efficiency of the engine is what gives me here. Look at this. On Minmus, 50 thrust to weight is way too much. It really is way too much. But you've got 18, 17 delta V. Let's test. If I use these liquid fuel engines, let's see what we get if we use these instead in like 2x symmetry. Come on. If I take those off, that's 7 thrust to weight with 1630. And what did I get from these? 1817. So I have way too much thrust to weight, but I get better delta V out of it. I just get more capability using these engines, even though they have an insane. Yeah, 50 thrust to weight. Yes, Orange Flamey Phoenix. Use monoprop and the monoprop radial engines. The monoprop's even more inefficient, honestly. The monoprop is even more inefficient. I don't like the monoprop. I'll give a look at it. For you, I will give a look at it. You're flattered. I have 1,700 of you. Guys, why are some things in chat red? Those are questions being highlighted. Aqualux. Aqualux, let me look at that. I know that I just got a, what, 1817 Delta V, and the cost of the craft is $45.65. Let's try it with monoprop, and let's see what we get from monoprop with the same sort of craft design here. I'm going to take that off. I'm going to go back to my monoprop containers. I'm going to have to... Oh, okay, good. I don't have to buy it. Let's put that on there like that. Let's put that on. I'm going to have to put a significant monoprop supply on the station if I do this. So there's that. And then if I use... Oh, I might not have the radial. No. How much do these cost? 400? I'll unlock them. I'm going to spend 4,000 just to see if this works. The monoprop engines. You know, there's not really anything wrong with putting them out here. But we could put them right here. In 2X symmetry. These engines are terrible. 2639 Delta V. That's actually very interesting. 2639 Delta V? Really? That's a lot more. The LV-1R is part of the contract, but I'm not going to design my lander for a one-time contract, which is a ton, but it was as a means to come back. It wouldn't be very efficient. I'm not trying to get back. Folks, welcome to Kerbal Space Academy Help Desk. I am Dos Valdez. That is actually really great. Those little monoprop engines with the 23.91 thrust to weight, 2639 Delta V, that is tons of Delta V out of them. I am actually impressed. They don't weigh anything is the thing. They don't weigh anything. You're right. He can, Stephen J. He can. But he can't carry the science containers along with him. I will actually do this. I have never done this before. I've never used these monoprop engines, but I will do it. I will do this. Thank you. That was actually really cool. I appreciate you. I do appreciate you. Does the docking approach technique apply to rescuing a guy? Yes, it does. Tiger Race, it does. I'm trying to get a rescue mission, and I'm going to knock out a bunch of these Minmus missions. I have a lot of hours. Surprise, I'm here. I have a lot of hours is all that I can say. Orm Flaney Phoenix, I love this game, and I love making people excited about science. I am totally going for this. I am definitely going to do this. This is actually really cool. Because, look, I can totally put these on here. Where is my center of mass? Okay. The center of mass is even well-oriented. And I will put some of those on like that. And then I will put some more of them on like this. And we're just going to use an all-RCS Minmus Explorer lander. You made it to the moon. What do you do? This dude. Celebrate. Plant a flag. Yes. Kinslape, you're right. Oh, I have monoprop in the pod as well. You're right. I do have monoprop in the pod. Heck yeah. We could actually have emergency monoprop. That disconcerts me a little bit. That also disconcerts me. Wait a second. I've just turned off all the monoprop and it says I still have the same Delta V. I wonder if Kerbal Engineer is broken. Yeah, I don't know. I wonder if Kerbal Engineer is broken. I'm actually a little concerned about that. I've turned off all the monoprop. Maybe it just doesn't know about that. Cybertech, if you're here, man, I need your help, buddy. Where are you at, Cybertech? Those hold 250 units each now? They rebalanced the heck. They rebalanced the heck out of that monoprop, didn't they? They really did. It looks like KAR is broken, Delta Vs. I think that Kerbal Engineer doesn't know what's going on there. Ah, yes. Leon, I have videos on that right now. I'm not doing that. Cybertech! There he is. Dude, Cybertech. Look, in Kerbal Engineer, I have these little 01, 010 monoprop engines. And whenever I disable this, it doesn't change the Delta V in Kerbal Engineer. You see that? The little 010 monoprop engines don't seem to understand disabling that. Let me add some weight to this thing and see if it decreases the Delta V. Yeah, adding weight does decrease the Delta V, but Kerbal Engineer doesn't seem to be paying attention to the monopropellant fuel storage being disabled. Just wondering. I don't know if that's maybe just add it to your bug list right quick or something like that. Thanks for dropping by too, Cybertech. I really do appreciate it. I really do appreciate you being here, man. You always support me. just by hanging out. Space Plane Constructions, Banana Punchers. I'm going to be doing that tomorrow, and I have lots of videos on YouTube on that. I have lots and lots. I have lots and lots of explanations on that. Let me see here. These engines are bad. Let me tell you why these engines are bad. I'm going to switch build aid to engine mode. Look at the thrust vector for these engines out of the box, right? The thrust vector for these engines out of the box is actually on an angle. Anytime you have thrust being applied to a craft at an angle, you're wasting delta V, because some of the thrust in this direction is going to cancel out some of the thrust in this direction. It doesn't matter if they're pointed in like this or out like that or whichever way. Anytime you're applying thrust at an angle to where you want your delta V to be spent, you're wasting delta V. You don't ever want angles like that. You just don't want... Thank you, Capsiero. You just don't ever want that. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to hold down W, and I'm going to change those things so they're pointed straight in. Like that. It looks like I did one too many clicks. There you go. All right, so they're never going to point exactly right down. This right here should be good, though. You don't want to be applying that thrust as an angle. I know that it looks cool, but you're wasting delta V anytime you do that. That's the exact same reason... That's the exact same reason that you never put your monoprop on at 45 degrees like that. Because look, if I go into translation mode, do you see how that's being applied at an angle to the intended direction of motion? That is a waste. That'll actually make me spin. But that is a waste of delta V right there. You don't want that. You don't ever want thrust being applied at angles because you're just wasting your delta V. Part of it goes into canceling itself out. So we'll put those like that. This little lander is looking good. How much delta V does the pod have with those engines and no extra monoprop? That's actually very interesting. I just tested everything works fine with monoprop. Interesting. I don't know. I've got the latest version of Kerbal Engineer. So I'm not sure. You can actually turn it on and off and it changes the delta V. Mine is not doing that for some reason. We'll get to the bottom of it. How much delta V does the pod have without that? I like this. This can basically send me anywhere, because the purpose of this is going to be bouncing around biomes on Minmus, right? I think I'm just going to go with this. I think I'm just going to go with this so that we can get on with the mission. I'm definitely going to need lights. You beat the cat planet? I don't know what that means. I'm definitely going to be going with lights in 1x symmetry here. Oh, never mind that monoprop's going to be spraying up on the tank a little bit, up in the window. That's okay. That's okay. That's with 1x symmetry. Do you have YouTube? Absolutely. Here you go, man. I do have a YouTube. I do have a YouTube. Wow. Das Valdez, that's on KSP TV when I stream over there. Let's put a spotlight as well. All right, guys. I am going to stop reading chat for just a minute so that I can get on with the mission here. I am going to stop reading chat, so bear with me for just a minute. Let's actually try to... Oh, when things get applied at an angle, you can't tuck it in as well. Interesting. Didn't know that. All right, that's okay. A little bit more. For fashion's sake. Okay, then this. There you go. And then we'll tuck it in a little bit. I've never been able to do this before, and I really like being able to tuck the lights in so that they look a little bit better. Alright, let's turn off RCS build aid. There we do. Chat is distracting. Purple lights, I'm just going to leave it like this. Lights, legs, and solar spells. Press F to get relative translation on gizmos. Oh, really? Press F. That's right, you can change it. I totally forgot about that. Thank y'all for reminding me. I need to put some more science on here. Landing legs. We don't need no stinking landing legs. That's what we use for landing legs on Minmus right there. That's how we do it. Honestly, that is how we do it on Minmus. We use those for our landing legs, and we should be good to go. I'm not going to change the color of the lights for now. I'm just going to leave it like that. Let me put the rest of the science on here, and let's get going with this. We are definitely going to want to have a thermometer. Yes, I said thermometer. We're going to unlock this, because we'll take a seismic accelerator. The unfortunate thing is that we also have the pressure map barometer, but we don't really need any pressure. We don't really need any barometer readings. I will put an antenna on it, just in case. There you go. Oops, I put those on with 2x symmetry. You always got to look out for that. These are smaller. Are these not slightly smaller, or am I just crazy? I don't know. Done, landed on the moon for DOS homework. Nice, Josh Wu. Congratulations. Congratulations. Does the lander can have a window in it now? It does have an IVA for sure. That should be good to go. I should have plenty of RCS. 2307, so that was going down. All right, I think we're good to go. I honestly wish that these here. I want a little bit more clearance on the docking port just for safety's sake. That looks okay. Yeah, that looks okay. They've always been that size? I don't know. It just... I may be nutso. Yeah, I may be nutso. You're right. Did I miss anything? Why do I have two antennas? I don't want two antennas. The game should just know when I don't want two of something on here. It's a thermometer. Did I miss... Oh, that would actually be really cool, but then I couldn't upload it. I don't have any other science experiments. The pressure map barometer? Nah, we don't really need that. How much Delta V do I need to go anywhere on Minmus is what I want. A ladder? You know, I could put a ladder on there just for... You don't need one on Minmus, but it's really just for kind of... You know... Yeah, we could just give him a little ladder. It's okay. Just... Yes. That RCS port is actually bugging me out from a realistic reality perspective. Is that wigging anybody else out? We need power generation. We do need power generation. I don't really like having that thing there. Do you have a downward-facing light? I have two. Yes, I do. It's for the swag. What? I don't really like having these here. I'm not sure if there's plans for dual monitor support, Cheese Lover. I don't like having these here. You know... I'm going to be... Since this is all RCS powered, I'm going to do something that I normally don't like to do. I'm just going to put more RCS than I need on there. Because I am going to have to be doing those tricky landings on top of the support. So I'm going to do it like this. We'll be okay. We'll be okay. That's way more RCS than it needs. It really is way more RCS than it needs. It does need batteries, dorsal batteries, you're right. Good catch. Good catch. Who said that? Where was it? Chris. It does need a dorsal battery, and it's got to have some sort of power generation. Full screen windowed mode. You can do that, Phoenix. That's the thing you can do. We can actually put these on here. We're just going to do solar panels. That's going to hit my antenna, isn't it? Oh, we could always put it like this. 1, 2, 3. Nope. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 45 degrees. Then we can tilt them down. Oh, buddy. Not from there, we can't. What's the easiest way to do that? All right, here's the easiest way to do that. Get the entire root node. Go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 so that the VAB has new symmetry. Maybe there's one of the new tweakables I could use for this, but I'm a little old school and I know how to do this the old school way. There we go. That'll do. Okay, there we go. That's okay. And then we'll just move the antenna to be like this in 1x symmetry. All right, that's actually okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oops, I kept going the wrong way, didn't I? Yes, I did. It bothers me that this VAB doesn't have a flag. There we go. Did I miss anything else? Did I miss anything else? Dude, Drunk Chocolate Milk, what's going on? Installing a mono RCS port at the middle of the quad port. I could think that, but I think I'm just going to go with this. I put two. I guess I could put two. I just want tons of... I need tons of control. You can tilt them and then rotate them. Okay, use solar sails. That's not a good idea. The isotopic generators. They're heavy. They're heavy, so I'm not going to use them for this mission. Downward-facing lights, but I like it for fashion. Plans for dual monitor support, okay, got that one. I got the downward-facing lights, solar panels and batteries, got it. I may need more batteries, maybe. You're nutso. Goo containers. I don't think that the goo containers are going to cause docking issues. You got a chute. I'm going to Minmus, so I don't need the chute, Teflon Mike. Did we get a shout-out for Teflon Mike? Teflon Mike, by the way. Kerr is not updating the Delta V. It is, I'm just putting physicsless parts on it. Let's put a little bit more battery juice on here. That should be, honestly, enough battery to get him through the cold Minmus-y nights. We could actually tuck it in a little bit if we wanted to. That looks good. Why does everything seem smaller? I don't know. Landing legs, I don't need them. I'm on Minmus, and the impact tolerance of the goo container is 12 meters per second. Those right there make excellent landing legs. I really do wish that we had a docking port junior. Do we have that unlocked yet? We don't yet have the docking port junior. I really wish that I could put a docking port junior on top of this. I really do wish. Jeez. I really do wish that we had the docking port junior. Can we unlock that? This is going to be the Minmus Science Lander. There you go. Save it. Let me go see if I can get the docking port junior. Oh, no. No, we're going to send a shuttle or something to go pick up the science. We're going to send a shuttle or something to pick up the science. The MicroStrut landing legs, the one next to the... I don't need them. I don't need landing legs because I can land on the goo containers. I can totally land on the goo containers. Let's see. Can I unlock this yet? It's somewhere up here, isn't it? Yeah, that's where it is. I honestly think that that's worth it. And let me show you why. Just for the docking port junior. I'm going to unlock that. And I'm going to unlock the docking port junior. Done deal. Okay, let me show you what I'm going to do here. Oh, a probe core would be great as well. Does the Xbox version of Twitch work for credits? If you're in chat, if you're logged into chat, it should work for that, yes. Now that I've got the smaller probe... Why don't I have the flat probe core? I thought I unlocked the flat probe core. This is the Hex. That's not really what I want. This is the Octo. The Hex is an upgraded version. Well, let's just unlock it. It's honestly a little too tall for what I want to do. Well, here, we could give it a... We could totally do this, yeah. It's a great trick, because why carry the weight of landing legs when you could have something that does science and landing legs? That is what we want to do. People be tweeting at me. Yeah, there you go. Okay. All right, so I'm going to do this like this. In watch. I'm going to have an upgradable flight computer. I am going to put the docking port junior on the top of it like this. I'm going to put another docking port junior on the top of it. And because I don't have everything I want unlocked right now, I'm actually going to put this probe core up here on this docking port. And whenever I get more parts, like the gravimeter and that sort of stuff, unlocked, I can actually undock this guy and I can replace the new nav computer on it. That is totally a thing that I can do. Your target landing stream. Yes, I do have target landings up there. Tall, you can move it now. Oh, no, but this is fine. I'm not gonna put it up there. I'm going to replace this flight computer by undocking and redocking a new flight computer to it. That is what I want to be able to do at some point. We'll do that in a future mission. But that right there is an upgradable flight computer. Super sensitive science experiment. I don't think that the goo containers... It looks a little bit wacky like that, but that's okay. We'll be able to upgrade that in the future. Yes, that is red. That is red. Tris King, Raw Solid, Corrupted Gaming, Juice Stein, Corrupted Gaming, I got you. Who else did I get? Jonathan TV, this dude, Wicked Kiddo, that guy. The ultra creative names there. All right, replace your bottom heavy docking port and the ones on the base. I am okay with this one. The miniature docking ports are harder to target, so since I'm going to be doing a vertical docking with this, I'm going to stick with the larger one. It gives me a bigger target, and it gives me more magnetic power. It does. Did I miss anything else? What is up, Swexy? What is up, Hellion? Did I miss anything else? Speak now, forever hold your peace. I know this looks ridiculous, but I'm going to go with it. You know, for a test, let's do this for a test. I'm clipping. Wait, why can't I click on that one? I clipped that down and I made it a little bit less tall. Come on. Why can't I click on that one? That's interesting. Okay, there we go. I'm flattening it out some. Do y'all see that? I hope that docks. I hope. I don't know if that's going to dock or not. Look for a higher resolution flag. Somebody was working on it, Spartan. Sith Wizard is here too. What is going on? Wow. Have I been to Elu? Absolutely. Why does everybody always ask that? I have definitely been to Elu. I'm actually doing something dangerous here. And I'm clipping that docking port down in a little bit. Let me see what it looks like. That should be okay. I did set it down in, but that does look a little bit more low pro. And there's our upgradable flight computer that we can redock to it. It would be cool if we put it on one side, but we're just not going to worry about it. Okay, we could also put more science experiments up there as well. Test the docks before you depart. Nah, that's not how we roll. 2164. What radial monoprop tanks do I have? I've got the stratified ones that hold 150. How do these only hold 150 and those hold 200? These used to hold what? 150. And then I've got these that hold 60. Yeah. Arc, this is a thrust away to 21 because it's relative to the body of Minmus where the gravity is very low. We're designing this for use on Minmus. On Kerbin, it could actually take off from Kerbin as well. But Minmus is where this is going to be operating. All right, we should be good. Let me use the new part here. Let me use the new part container. I'm going to set the root node to the docking port on the bottom. Like that. I can then come over here and I can set it as a sub-assembly. And this is going to be... I wish that is buggy. This is going to be the science lander. Save. And we should be good with this. We should be good with this. Close to 500 viewers. Heck yeah. Heck yeah. Guys, thank you for joining me. I do appreciate it. Thrust limit the engines. It's actually not a bad idea. That's actually not a bad idea. Because 50% thrust is going to give me 10 thrust to weight. And that should be enough. Yeah, 10 point... Yeah, that's a good idea, thrust limiting it. That is a good idea. So many joins all of a sudden. Welcome, folks. Welcome to my stream. But now I need to thrust limit it. That's okay. Let's just save this. Let's go back to the Minmus science mission. I'm trying to do a rescue mission here. Select the ship to load is going to be the KSA Minmus. Where is it at? Minmus Science Station. There we go. And now watch. Since I set that as a sub-assembly, I can actually come over here and I'm going to transport it one way. I can go to the sub-assemblies like that. I can grab the science lander since that's the root node. And I can put it right like that. Now, is that a legitimate strategy? It absolutely is for storing or transporting something. Because a docking port has two functions. A docking port can either dock two things together, or it can operate as a one-time decoupler. So it'll actually give me something in there that allows me to decouple that, which is really cool. I can decouple that, and then every future time that I do it, I can land on one of these things. So that is a good idea right there. Rescue mission for what? For a Kerbal. Guys, again, please don't abuse the highlighting. I would appreciate it if you didn't abuse the highlighting. I try to answer all the questions, but if too many people are abusing the highlighting, I can't really. It's actually really difficult. So I do appreciate it if you don't abuse the highlighting. Now we're going to need lots of RCS storage on here. All the parts start out horizontal. I don't actually know. Maybe somebody could actually help you though with that. I don't know. All the parts start out horizontal. Are you in the space plane hangar? Maybe you need to be in the VAB would be my first guess. This is so confusing to me. How do you get back to... parts. Yeah, that really needs some interface work. I'm not. It's not going to leave anything on the cupola. The cupola will be nice and clean. We've got that. We're not going to need chutes for anything. Now we need power generation and RCS storage for the station. We're totally going to need that. So let me put some RCS storage on here. There you go. We could put this in 4X symmetry. Actually, that's going to be okay. 4X symmetry. We should almost just do the entire thing. Jeez. We should do the entire thing. Because that's only two refuels for the lander. And I can't put... What does this carry? How does that still only carry 750, but this one's been upgraded to 250? That doesn't make any sense to me at all. That one there carries 80, and the radial mount cylindrified ones carry what? 150. Jeez. So these are now the new way to store RCS in bulk. I guess I could do that. That's going to put the center of mass up higher. So what I'd really want to do for that is flip it around. I believe, right? Yeah. I think that's good. What else did I miss? Tell me what else I missed. I missed a probe core. I think I want to put these down, lower. Maybe the large tanks can hold more pressure. Maybe the larger tanks can hold more pressure? You mean the smaller tanks can hold more pressure? Or the larger tanks can hold less pressure, maybe? I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. We'll have to see. You should use fold-out solar panels. I am going to do the fold-out solar panels. Trumpet, you're right. We do need some fold-out solar. We need some power generation. I think for the purposes of looking awesome, which is a thing, it's very important. I think we're actually going to put these on with symmetry. Like this. See? Like that. And then we could do this. And on Minmus, those landing legs should be more than enough. That should be fine. What's the weight capacity of both of them? Oh, that's a good question. Accent lighting. Oh, you're right. Accent lighting. We do need lights for fashion, and we need accent lighting. I honestly could just make the entire thing RCS propelled. What's that about Losar Orbit? Please, surprise, don't spam questions. Everybody, if you're asking the questions multiple times, especially if it's a trolley question like, have you ever been into a low solar orbit? It's not my first rodeo. Yes, you can do that, but please don't spam the questions over and over again. In fact, if you keep spamming the questions, the mods are probably going to time you out, just so that I can continue looking at the things highlighted in red. Those engines won't work. No, we won't need parachutes. We're going to Minmus. All right, thank you, surprise. I know I haven't... there's so many new viewers. I really do appreciate you, though. Thank you so much for being cool about it. Let's see here. So many viewers with the question and answers. That looks good. Where is my center of mass? It's a little higher now because the lander's on tight, but that's going to be okay. We'll be able to land. We don't have much fuel for the landing, but that's okay. I'm not going to make it all monoprop. Silas, it's actually called the sun. I thought that as well. I was like, nah, that's not going to happen. The gravity on Minmus is very low. I need power generation from somewhere, so let's put some power generation on here. There we go. I don't think I'm going to take the Gigantors. I think these cost a little more, and they weigh a little bit more, but they're fashionable. They are very fashionable, and I could do something like this. Guys, this is 100% a fashion thing. If I put those on like that, that is really just for fashion. I could actually put them on the top and the bottoms and make kind of a fuel nacelle sort of thing. That's actually pretty interesting. All right, best time to take crew reports. Ah, watch me, Valison. I'm going to be doing that. Kerbals won't die today. We should be good. We should be good. I could totally make, like, engine nacelle sort of things. But I don't think we're going to need it. The craft weight, I'm not worried about the craft weight. The craft weight's okay. Does RCS require fuel tubes for radial transfers? No, it does not. You can just transfer it around. Although I can't actually transfer fuel yet. I can now because I upgraded the R&D facility. How much Delta V does that cost us? 2580, 2614 for that fashion. Ah! Can you land the smaller lander separately so your center of mass is lower? I'm really not worried about it, guys. We'll be okay. We will be okay. Let's just get this mission going. Let's just get this thing out to Minmus. I think we've got everything... Oh, not before I put solar panels on it. Because what I was going to do... Change your flag again. Thank you. I really do try to keep up with chat, guys. It's kind of hidden in there. But you can see... Oh, wow. The flags are just all hidden. That's okay. I do. I've got them uploaded to YouTube. AR12 Gaming. With the refollow, dude. Welcome back. So what I was going to do was this. I was going to put those on. Then I was going to put my solar panels like this. Which one? Is that the two? Yeah. Let's do the 2x3s for this mission. We'll put these on like that to put the solar panels at a bit of an angle. And we're just going to call it a day. That's out of... It's not going to hit anything. Yeah, we're good. All right. Good deal. Used on your survey mission. Excellent. I like it. It's pretty big. But I like it. Thank you for sharing with me. Oh, let's strut the lander in. And then let's get this thing to space. Cost about 1,000 to get out to Minmus. So we'll just go 4x symmetry. and strut the lander in like that. That looks good. It'd be better to go from the lander, though. There you go. All right, that's just for transport. Those struts will break off whenever we get there. And we need to... It's all good, Air 12. Don't worry about it, man. I'm honestly a little bit concerned about this. I don't want it there, honestly. If I don't have the big docking ports, I don't want my primary connection with a big station or a science lander like this to be that. Yeah. How does Twitch contract doing? It takes them a while to get back to you. It really does. So I'm not worried about it right now. There is that. Do I have the decoupler? A stack separator would leave a bunch of junk, though. I wish I had the big docking ports. But I just don't right now. That just is what it is. All right. So to Minmus. I know I'm going to need over 1,000 to get to Minmus. Let's see what I've got for that. So I'm going to use these class of fuel tanks. If I put that with a poodle, will it get me to Minmus? Survey says... 971. That could get me very, very, very close to a Minmus encounter. It needs a little bit more fuel, and I am good to go on that. And again, this is just going to be kind of a dumb part. It's just a dumb transfer stage. If I had a docking port, I would put something in a permanent orbit around Minmus, but I don't have the docking port right now. So I'm just going to put a little bit more fuel on here like this. I need to unlock these tanks, apparently. There you go. And that looks great. 1357 is a good Minmus amount. That's way too much thrust away, though, but I'm just going to go with it. Why did you change the thrust to go from lander to the science station? It was just a fashion thing. What kind of headphones? X31s. Take it easy, Orange Flamey Phoenix. I appreciate you stopping by. If I missed any of your questions, I do apologize. Let me look. Looks everything. What's the red fuel tank thingy? What do you mean? I don't know what the red fuel tank thingy is. If I missed that questions. But anyways, take it easy. Take it easy. Yeah, right. Jesus, right. Whew. Jeez, oh, Pete. That was definitely uncalled for. Oh, you know what? We're not in... We're still on Minmus. Ah, we need to go to Kerbin. 0.56 thrust weight on Kerbin. I'm feeling a lot better about that now. In atmospheric. All right, so 1357. Okay, so we're good to go. That's my Minmus transfer stage. He won't be calling again. Nice, thanks, Kamuji. We could come over here and put some struts like this. This is an important thing. 4x symmetry up to there. It was really just a fashion, like a personal preference sort of thing. That really didn't mean anything. We are going to need to get it into orbit now. This is actually going to be the pricey part of our mission. This is going to be a $100,000 launch, I think. What's on the hotbar to the right of the parts picker? Oh, this hotbar up here? These are different placement modes that we got in 0.90, the new beta one. This is career on hardest, Coburn. This is career on hardest. And you know what? We also need to test these things. We have to put these little things somewhere. So look, I could put one of these. These things weigh almost nothing. So I could put that right there, and I could put its radial counterpart over here. Seems legit. We'll just leave them there. Need more batteries on the main base. And some ability to transmit science. Yes, we do totally need that. Good catch! Good catch. Who was that? Hoffinator, thank you for reminding me. I got distracted and I didn't put them on there. You, sir, are a lifesaver. Thank you so much. I'll do this with 1x symmetry. I will... Oh, that's going to have a solar panel clipping into it. It's okay. We just won't destroy that solar panel. Or we won't care about what's happening there, basically. Let's unlock that thingy. And I'll put my... There we go, that looks good. I almost wish I could take that solar panel off, but I can't. There's not a way to do it. There's not a way to do it. And see, the problem is when this expands... Ah, well, that is what it is. So let me put the bigger batteries on there. I'm going to unlock those. And I'm going to put battery banks down here low, just in 2x symmetry. And that should be, what, 1,600 battery juice? How much do those have? 400 each, so that just added 1,600, which is more than enough to clean up the science and stuff. We should be okay. All right, what else did we miss? Had to head off around the time. Giveaway. Radial in, radial out. I did go over the radial in and radial out, but I'll show you again. Put 3 solar panels on the other fuel cells on 1x symmetry each. Yes, that is what I would have to do. So I'll put those in 1x symmetry, and then I have to go around 3 different times and put them on. And then that actually, the landing legs aren't on, right? There you go. The landing legs weren't right. Did y'all see that? Ah, so annoying. Come on. Get off of it, go down to 1x symmetry, then put it back, come around, and do the same thing on this one. And then that one doesn't have one, and then that one's okay. All right, we're good to go. Ah, we got it. Whoa, Noob K! You never send a message, Noob K, but I always appreciate it. I always do appreciate it. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate the support. This is my job, and that's the first donation of the evening. So thank you so much for the support. 2x symmetry. 2x symmetry. All right, did I miss anything else here? We're fine. Can't you just make them 1x6? I could, but I want these. I think they look better. I think that they look better. How fun career mode is. You got to all stage 2. Excellent. All right. We're good to go. Let's get it to Minmus now. That is okay for a Minmus transfer stage. I'll be okay with that. I've already made the decision on the solar panels. Move on. Move on. I wanted those on there for fashion, is why they're there. Oh, and Teflon Mike did say to put some accent lighting. So I'm just going to put one light like this, honestly. And that's going to be our accent lighting. Alright, that's good. So now I'm going to A-Moon. Now we just need to get this thing into orbit. This kicker stage is definitely... What is that? Why is the center of lift up? This kicker stage is definitely going to be skipper-powered. Okay, there's the skipper. I gotta unlock it. Alright. And I need 1.5 thrust to weight and 1500 delta V. That's only 0.83. Ooh. That's 1500 delta V, but that's 0.83 thrust to weight. The skipper's not going to be able to do it. Really? Hum. I'm not okay with 0.03 thrust to weight. I could always just take some delta V out of that and put a half tank in. Let's see what this looks like. 13 with 0.94. I want 0.15, but I'm not rendezvousing with anything. It is all vanilla parts, but I think this is good to go. So now we just need to put these decouplers on here. Some purple lighting. I'm not going to change the lighting colors this time. I'm just going to leave the lighting stock. And we could put this on. I'll try 2x skippers first, because I hope that 2x skippers work. We will have to see, though. What is that bright red fuel tank? Oh, that's my Dr. Pepper fuel tank. Surprise, it's my Dr. Pepper fuel tank. Oh, wah, yes. I win. DOS, we should keep score with the DOS ninjuing. Delta V's, you're abusing the highlighting. Don't abuse the highlighting so that I can actually get to people that are asking me things. I did. It's not an engine. It's a fuel tank, guys. But I did make the Dr. Pepper fuel tank. Now I'm doing my super special KSA. Alright, that seems legit. Hazy Gaming, I can't wait for you to get that much needed partner. You deserve it, buddy. You really do. Don't ever think twice and keep pushing forward. Love from Portland, Oregon. Hazy Gaming, thank you for the support. I really do appreciate it. I really, really, really do appreciate the support. Thank you so much, Hazy. I mean, the money is very important, but just like the props and the say and keep on going and that sort of stuff, I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much for the support. It really does mean a lot to me. Let's tuck those in a little bit. Yeah, that looks good. All right, thank you, Hazy, again. Heck yeah, it is. It is a can of Dr. Pepper. I wasn't pulling your leg. We're going to need this at some point, so I'm going to go ahead and unlock the Big Orange tanks. And then we're going to have to put mainsails on this for sure. I'm rapidly approaching the point in this career. Fallison with another $25. I know it's not a bunch of money. You're wrong. That's a huge deal to me. Wanted to say thanks and give a little. I've owned KSP for over a year, but been scared to play till I found you. Keep it up. Love the stream. Addicted to KSP. Valison. That's a huge amount of money to me. That is a huge amount of money. Let me tell you something. My other job, my part-time job that I do on the weekdays, we got transcoding too. Heck yeah. 1121. My other job that I do is after-school programs for kids, right? And I can go and I can take care of 20 kids for an hour, kindergartners through third and fourth graders usually. I can take care of those 20 kids for an hour, and $25 is what I get from it. And that doesn't include the hour that it takes me to drive there and the hour that it takes me to come back. So I can spend 3 hours doing the after-school programs for kids, and I get paid $25 for doing it. So that is a huge amount of money. I really do appreciate it. Don't ever think that that's not a large amount of money, because I really do appreciate it. Did not get partnered yet, no. That was just transcoding. We just got transcoding. You're up 64 kilo followers. Dope fish, you're right. Valison, thank you so much. Best stream, I don't know about that, but I really do appreciate it. Transcoding. Hazy Gaming and Valison. And the other one was Noob K. Thank y'all. I really do appreciate it. Am I overweight with a part count? Oh, I'm overweight with those tanks. Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. Not cool. I am overweight with the tanks. Well, we may have to refuel this in orbit then. That may just be what it is. We may just have to refuel that in orbit. I did not realize that yet. As soon as we put those down, that's what sent us overweight. Quark, thanks for the follow. I really need to move that. Those tanks weigh a lot. We're just going to have to refuel this in orbit. We really are. If you do after-school programs, have you ever heard of FIRST Robotics? No, I do. I do a company called Mad Science, right? Mad Science is what I do. This is hardcore mode. It is. So we can't do that. We're not going to be able to do that. We're just going to have to get it into orbit. That using the entire lander is barely going to get it into orbit. That's going to do nothing. Wow. Well, let's see what we can do here. Maybe we just have to refuel it, and we use this as both the kicker and the transfer stage. And we're just going to have to refuel it. Seems legit. Actually, that looks really cool. So what is that? 3349 using the entire fuel in this kicker stage? Let me make sure the staging is correct as well. So many follows, I can't keep up with it. I am such a noob. And on that note, drink. Wow, let's see here. IS not working. Sorry about that. With the separation thrusters you were testing on, I think, Sunday work. They would. Low fuel amount slightly. We wouldn't get into orbit, though. We wouldn't get into orbit. Dr. Pepper commercial. I'd love to be in a Dr. Pepper commercial. Don't send the tanks up full. We just wouldn't be able to... why don't we just not fuel this? Why don't we use this as both our kicker and our transfer stage? This should do it. Look. If we put a skipper on here, like this. Smooin, aerospace engineer here. Keep up the good work, man, Smooin. I appreciate the donation. Thank you so much. I always thought I was going to be an aerospace engineer. I had planes hanging in my house and, you know, little model planes, and I would fly model rockets when I was a kid. And then I got into computers and the dot-com boom happened, and I never went to aerospace engineering. My life could have been totally different. But I appreciate what you do. Thank you for giving us cool things. I think you should probably make more than lawyers, for sure. For lawyers, for sure, yeah. But I really do appreciate the support. That right there will barely get us... That's still not going to quite get us into orbit. And we're 140 tons. Look at that. I like space. You're good at space. Here's money. Go more space, guy who likes space. MKA696. Thank you for the support, too. Gosh. Oh my gosh, I should have gone. I almost applied to Embry-Riddle. I really almost applied. I got waitlisted at MIT. I had a large scholarship to MIT from the ROTC program, and I got waitlisted, so I didn't go to MIT, and I didn't do the aerospace engineering, and here we are. Ay, 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 ay. Just tuned in. Chops like pudding, what's going on? Donation hype. Folks, everybody with the donations, I really do appreciate y'all. We are just barely, we're 0.9 tons over. We're going to have to refuel it anyways. So you know the answer to that is to take this monoprop out. And this is going to allow us to go into orbit. So we're gonna, when we refuel it, we're going to have to refuel the fuel and the monoprop. And then we will refuel this guy up in orbit. Look, we can do this for a lot cheaper, I bet you. 4413. This goes into orbit all day long. We don't even need the mainsails, so we can decrease the mission cost a little bit. And then we're going to have to do a separate mission to actually fuel it. What is that, 1.07 on the pad? You know the solution to that. Unfortunately, the solution to that... Scary Fest! Space! 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 Are we going to space yet? Are we in space yet, Dad? I like space. Do you like space? Space! Thank you for the support. The toolbar does work. North Carolina, aerospace. It looks like you are doing aerospace to me. I'm not, guys, I'm not a real aerospace engineer. I really am not. I just enjoy this game, and I like getting people. I think it's very important that we get people excited about science and technology and stuff. And this is how I can get people excited about science and technology. I can talk about it, and I can hype it up, and all that sort of stuff. That's how I can get people excited about it. Good night, Irene. That's one! Dope Fish! I don't always have time to watch KSA, but you are reliably informative and entertaining. Keep up the fantastic work. Dope Fish, thank you. That's how you pronounce that name, by the way. Dope Fish. What is it? Can I do it? G as in enough. T-I as in caution. O as in... Ah! This is the part I always forget. O as in... O as in... Ish. Ish. Sith Wizard. Merry Christmas, bro. O as in... God, thank you for the support. Dope. GH is in enough. So F is in fish. O as in, it's like girl or something. What is it? Ooh, O. O is in, no, y'all are going to have to get it. I can't remember it right now. Women. Thank you, women. O is in women. Women. The O in women is an I sound. And then T-A or T-I as in caution. Because in caution, T-I makes a sh sound. That's why it's dope fish. There we go. All right, look at this. We're solving here. Maybe we're going to blow up. We don't know. Women, you got it. You did get it. Thank you. So there, if we light all of our engines in the main stage, we're going to have 1.62 on the pad, 3956 to orbit. That's perfect. We may need just a teeny tiny bit more delta V. But look, I'm going to actually put fuel lines running in so that we... This is actually called onion staging. 4631. I love it. All right. That is what we want to see right there. 4631. And we have to be very, very careful about these separators. Do you see what I'm doing there? Do you see how I'm using all three of my engines? And I'm not wasting... There you go. I'm not wasting this engine. I'm actually using it on the pad. That's very important to me. You knew you'd get it. Yeah, there you go. Somebody help me, though. Onion staging. I'm crying already. You're hilarious. I hope this decouples. I really think that we need some sort of simulation mode. I really do hope that this decouples correctly. I'm putting these down here. We're going to need to strut it in as well, for sure. So I could strut this to the main payload like this. You know something? We've got so much delta V. Let's fashion this up just a little bit as well. Oh, I can't fashion it up. Wow, I'm lacking fashion parts. P.S. Don't try this in, don't try this in far or near, because this is not relevant for far or near. I'm going to have to go to 2x symmetry, it looks like. In strut. I thought they fixed that, and they didn't. Nope, they didn't fix it. That's so annoying that they didn't fix that. 1x symmetry, point of the part, switch it to 2x symmetry, that fixes it. Alright, got it. Go back to the struts. You know, I think this is just always going to be a thing with my streams. I like to read my chat, and therefore it takes longer for me to build things, but I like to read and talk to my chat, so that just is what it is. I think I just need to say that that's the case, you know what I mean? Is the claw. I've got the claw. What is you with these crazy Frankenships? I think it looks great. I think that it looks great. It's very fashionable. Don't try it near or far, but it's very fashionable. There is that right there. We're going to put that over there. That looks good enough. I'm very concerned about these. I'm very, very concerned about the decouple. And it just is what it is. 0.6 on the pad. That's because these aren't in the right place. And we're going to need 3 brave Kerbals to go out here. Wow, all those engines are going to go off at once. That's not what we want. We just want the science station engines to go next. Like that. And actually, for safety's sake, we'll activate the science station engines at the same time we decouple from the science station. It really is. Interacting with chat really is a part of what makes it so optimum. I started tech. Here are some cookies. Nom 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 nom. Thank you, I started tech. I star iTech. Or maybe just Star Tech. Either way, thank you for the support. Oh my gosh. Thank you for the support. You guys. Wow. Talk to your streamers. Everything more fun for everyone. I agree, Hazy Gaming. I do agree. I started tech. Thank you again for the support. Let me read chat. It's kind of a Frankenship, I know, but this just is what it is. I don't need them stood off as far, but I want it there from a safety perspective. I just unlocked the claw, so we'll be doing orbital cleanup later this week. Where are you going with this craft? Valison, we're going to Minmus. Do I have Separatrons? Yes, I put them on. Drink? Yes, I need that. I got the dope fish thing. I only respond to things in red, guys. When I scroll back through my chat, I only respond to things in red, but please don't abuse that. Do I like editor extensions? I've never used it. Anybody remember the first time we broke DOS with donations? It was a boot camp, and I made, like, yeah. Yeah. Okay, I've answered all the questions up to here, and I don't think I need to upgrade the launch pad. The ship is ridiculous. You love it. Yes, I am launching soon, Crusader. How are we in terms of weight? Now we're well underweight. Where are we going to dock to refuel? We need a refueling port. Let's just do it like that. We do need a refueling port. Good thing I remember that. Chat, why didn't you help me out? All this spam and nobody telling me that I didn't put a way to refuel this entire shenaniganry. That's your fault, not mine. Oh, brother. They didn't fix that. I don't understand why they didn't fix that. It's okay, though. Now we're good. And I'm just going to put a refueling port on here. Let's see. Refueling port is going to look like this. And have a clampatron on it. And put it right there in 1x symmetry. That is what we'll use to refuel. Noob K, that's another one. 250 for an Earthworm Slim shout out. Heck yeah, dude. Earthworm Slim is awesome. Watched him earlier because you hosted him. Cool cat. Merry Christmas to everybody in chat. Best wishes to everyone's families. Noob K, Earthworm Slim is amazing. He's out doing some errands and stuff like that in real life. I did invite him to come hang out with us, and he had some errands to do. But thank you so much. That is awesome support. Earthworm Slim is an amazing guy. Thank you so much. Whoa! So much, Noob K. Get Slim a link up for sure, because I love Earthworm Slim. He's one of the reasons that I kept streaming. I was like, wow, some of these people are just like playing a game and not, it's just kind of like, alright, whatever. But Slim was like the first streamer that I saw really like talking to his chat and like dressing up and having a lot of fun with it. And Slim is one of the reasons that I kept streaming. Exactly. Use the landing ports. I'm just going to put a refueling port. You're a little low. If you undock the lander... I can't undock the lander because I'll never be able to redock the lander. Able to code. I would make you a mod that as you were building a ship, it would go through the launch process and have a window that would tell you if there would be a problem. They've got that. They've got Wormen von Kerman as a mod that tells you if you're missing some things. They do actually have a mod that's like a checklist that checks through like batteries and power generation and all that sort of stuff. They do have that. Next Beginner Academy is going to be in 2 weeks, Mr. Cartoon. 2 weeks. I do the boot camp every other weekend. Or it's up on YouTube. You can totally watch it up on YouTube. Oh! Alright, I think we're good. Let me check all my staging here. 3 engines ignite. Check. No, you're not supposed to go there. You're supposed to go down here when we ignite the engines. Then we decouple those and fire their Separatrons. Check. The Werner Checker. There you go. Werner Checker is the mod. You're right. Then we just continue burning that engine after those decouple. Check. And it should be full of fuel because the fuel lines are going in the appropriate direction. Check. 4615 is more than enough to get us in See you on the flippy flop, clapping, fat, fat. Take it easy. Can I make a plane docking? That's going to be later or tomorrow. That's actually pretty close right there, ride car. That's actually pretty close. You're taking off refuel in orbit, then headed to Minmus. Yes, that is exactly. Do you have any future plans to stream or create content with Giant Waffle? That's up to him. I'd love to. I'd love to be Giant Waffle's Capcom and help him out in TeamSpeak or something. That is something that I really do enjoy doing. I don't even have to be on the camera or whatever. I could just be Capcom for him. That is absolutely a thing. You could use all the engines on that craft. Oh, I could use those other engines. I'm not going to now, though. But yeah, that is... I don't know. That's totally up to Giant Waffle. I just kind of met the guy. The title of the .90 shuttle tutorial. It was on KSPTV. Miley gives Becky, it would be on KSPTV. If I didn't say that earlier, I apologize. I did that on KSPTV last Monday. Right before the new Mark III space plane parts came out. That's why I did that. It's on KSPTV, so go to KSPTV, watch past broadcasts, and you'll see Craft Balance. There's one that I did Craft Balance last Monday. We should be good to go here. I'm going to save this. I'm really concerned about the decouple. I'm really concerned about the decouple. What can you do? Maybe things are going to blow up. If they blow up, then everybody dies. Since there's no escape pod on this. You have plenty of mass in Delta V to reveal your monoprop. I'm okay. I'm gonna have to launch a supply mission because all of these tanks are empty right now, see? DOS and Waffle will be so funny together, really, Matt Rule? We'll see. We will see. Hype, you're one of my favorite streamers. Very quickly, you got the Waffle love. You've been watching for Waffle for almost a year. Dude, well, thank you, Dr. Redstone. I appreciate that. I really do appreciate that. We have absolutely no way to save these Kerbals if it hits the fan. We have no way to save these Kerbals. We've got to fix this. Baker ejection seats. Yeah. You know what we could do? Because this is hard mode mission. Everybody dies. If this happens, everybody dies, which is a huge problem. But we could totally do this. Put a single parachute on it. You know what we could do? I'm going to purchase that chute. This would totally be a thing. Look, Kerbals would be fine. What's the worst that could happen? We could make decouplable parachute pods. Look. That would absolutely be an abort sequence thing. Vanguard parachute mods. No, I don't do that. And I don't think that would actually bring me down completely safely. But I think we could at least save the Kerbals. Lander can decouple with a parachute, then stage lock when you get to Minmus. I think that I'm just going to put these two chutes on here. I think that that's what I'm going to do. Because look, I could totally put chutes above the solar panels. Well, I've got little science experiments there right now. I think I'm just going to do these, then I could decouple them, right? I could totally just decouple them and not carry them. Because I'm going to take three Kerbals with me. And I'm worried about it. But I think maybe we're just going to try this. I'm so worried about the decouple. Let me actually set up the... I need to set up some action groups right quick. Really? Huh. Okay, well, we'll have to use this. We just have the abort, and I'm going to put these in the toggle panel for the brakes. So when I turn the brakes on, I can toggle these solar panels, which makes no sense to me. And then I do have abort. And for abort, I could totally deploy those chutes. I don't think I would want to deploy those chutes. For the abort, I think I would just want to do this. I would want to decouple that and fire something that would get me away safely, right? And fire these engines, maybe. Activate those engines and decouple. This is not a very safe. This still isn't very safe. But now we've got this. Alright, I'm a little concerned. I'm really honestly a little concerned here. But what can you do sometimes? And let's just fly it. 530 viewer hype, heck yeah. folks, thank y'all for watching me. I really do appreciate it. We're going to go to Minmus. We're trying to get a rescue contract. The engines do have fuel. They have a little bit of fuel right there. I'm going to leave that fuel in there. I took out the RCS. I didn't take out the fuel. This is KSP. When has safety mattered? Because this is shut down the lifter engines as well. Oh, that's a great idea, honestly. That's actually a really great idea. Shut down all the lifter engines in the abort stage. Thank you. You saved me with that one, or else that rocket would have gone through me and blown me up. Heck yeah. All right, let's see here. We've got all this stuff. I don't like using these. I really don't like using them. But it just is what it is. You need an abort mission for your abort mission. All right. At some point, there comes a time in each young Kerbal's life where it's just time to get in the rocket. And I do. I'm really concerned about the separation. But I think it's just time to get in the rocket and see if everybody dies. How much is this going to cost me when it fails, I wonder? 94,000? Well, it's not going to break the bank. Running a ship, tested a couple times. Test it. Now, Wolfboy King Howls, I don't do that in my hardcore career. You could totally do that. That is totally up to you. But I don't do that in my hard mode career. Let's put this sucker on the launch pad. Kerbal. Oh, wait. I'm not going to have Kerbals in here. I'm only going to have one Kerbal, and I need three. He doesn't need that. Doss is an expert. Don't put your best pilot in there. Jebediah Kerman. That's not cool. And it's a night landing. But the only way we can put more Kerbals in there is to go back in. Gosh. Can I just recover? Oh, I have to recover the vessel. That's right. So let's recover the vessel. I'm in hard mode career, Crusader X. I am in hard mode career. Those funds are hard fought. I only have 500,000. This is going to cost me 20% of my stuff right now. Let's go over. We can do it from here, I think, right? With that probe core on, could you fly it without Kerbals and send them up on the refueler? Oh, that actually makes a lot of sense. But we're not going to do that. I've got an upgraded pilot, Sherbals Kerman. Sherbals Kerman. We rescued him from orbit. Do I have an upgraded scientist? Sherbals and Durton, look at these guys. Sherbals Kerman. That guy's going on a Duna mission or something. Do I have a scientist? Here's Thompney Kerman. Do I have an upgraded scientist besides Bob? I think I'll send Bob out there. Bob will be the experiment. Bob will be the experienced crew member here. He can actually be the commander. He can be the mission commander because he's got two experience stars. And the other guys here, Command Pod Mark 1, Command Pod Mark 1, Command Pod Mark 1. Why are there three Command Pod Mark 1s? Oh, because we're on the wrong ship. Oh my gosh, that's right. That's the wrong ship. We actually wanted the KSA Minmus Science Station. There you go. And we don't want Jeb. We wanted Sherbals Kerman. He's been to Minmus, so he's coming back. Doss, wait for what? I know, we fixed it. I figured it out. I wouldn't have put him in the wrong ship. Sherbals Kerman is going to go in the cupola. And then Bob is going to go in the processing lab. And so is our engineer, Tumpney Kerman. Sherbals been to Minmus, so that's good. Bob Kerman is the scientist who's upgraded, so that's good. They're all cousins, yes. And we should be good to go. There should be a DOS Kerbal in mission control. Nice. You having a bug where you can't get into the VABs? Basically, when I'm in R&D, I can't get out. Do you know how to fix this? Shut down the game, open it up, and see if the bug recurs. If the bug is consistent, post up on the squad help forums. Or try a clean... Or actually, shut down the game, start it back up, see if the bug happens again. If the bug happens again, try a fresh install. Try a clean install. If you do a clean install and you still get the bug, post up on the help forums. Totally post up on the help forums. Flag, you're right, I do need to do the flag. Done deal, accept it now that we've got the right flag. This looks good. We've got a good crew in here. Sherbals, Tompney, and Bob. Let's go ahead and put them out on the pad. It's going to cost us 95K to launch. You need a tip for how to set up a moon mission. what you gain with the engineer and the scientist on the flight. The engineer can repair things like landing gear if they break, and the scientist gets a bonus. He's going to actually get a 10% bonus to his science returns. So that's why I'm taking those things. Will only one scientist work in the science lab, or you need two scientists? I think you just need one scientist and one other Kerbal to, like, be his little sweeping person. Let me see if I missed anything else. Yes, they are all cousins or something. We don't know, Matt Rule. They're Cylons. You haven't slept? Low to low. Working 2 hours, two next Tuesday, military exercise for the Royal Danish Recon. Wow! Dude, Lodonol. Thank you for what you do. First off, it's important for people who are interested, who are willing to go out there and be in the military and that sort of stuff. I don't even know what to really tell you about it. But I do appreciate you. And good luck, man. I'm glad you like it. There's a free demo to KSB if you want to try it. Oh, Crew Manifest. We do need Crew Manifest. The pilot helps it fly. You get more pilot control. Clones! They are clones. Can you stack that 10% bonus with more than one scientist? No, I think it's just one. It's the Kerbal who gets the science, so you can only have one Kerbal do it. Since I've got these guys in here, let's launch them. And then when I go over to help desk, I will do this. I will go to and start renaming Kerbals. We're 1.61 on the pad, so we're going to throttle up. We're going to panel lock. We're going to SAS engage. Final countdown. Here's the final check. Let's see what we've got here. Main engines, fire. Stages are actually launch clamps, decouple. Core engine, fire. Decouple, fire the separatrons and decouple the booster stages, okay. Final stage, decouple and fire the main tank, or the main payload. Shoots in their own stage just in case. Delete is going to be the emergency abort. Tannery, of course I remember you. There's truck stock crew fancer. No, but it's to rename them, Cap Sierra. It's to rename them to viewer names, which is what I'm going to do. Ah, yes. They're clones. Swexy Duckling. They're clones. Don't all ducks look alike? Does that mean that ducks are incestuous? No. Good try, though. Let's see if this works. It's the time in the young Kerbal's career when it's just time to launch the rocket. Yeah, Crew Manifest does work. I just need to install it. Let's go ahead. We've throttled up. We've panel locked. We've SAS engaged. We're full on fuel. We just removed the monoprop payload, so we're going to have to bring a big monoprop payload up there to refuel it. Is the part highlighting a mod? No, it's stock now, Luis. Your graphics card may not support it, unfortunately. And we are going to go ahead and just say 3, 2, 1 space. All right, we've got clean separation. We've got clean separation from the launch towers. We've got SAS engaged. We're going to go straight up till we get to 10K before we start the gravity turn. I'm not going to worry about the roll or pitch program here yet. I do believe it will be safer. Maybe I do need to worry about the roll program. Let's roll to dorsal here while we're going up to our 10K. So when we do this separation, we have equal gravity on both of the solid, on both of the liquid fuel boosters on the sides. So I am just going full throttle straight up till I get to 10K, and I'm rolling such that my dorsal side is facing west and my ventral side is facing east. Right? Like that. That looks great. All right, that was a good roll program. Now, whenever the side boosters decouple, they'll both have equal gravity. Instead of having one above you and below you, they'll have equal gravity on either side to put you off. You can learn how to make bases next. This is basically a base that I'm landing here. Now I'm going straight up until I get 10K. It looks like our tanks are going to take us well through 10K, which is a good sign. We'll get lots and lots of orbital velocity. We're leaving the cloud layer now. We're up to 9K. We're climbing up to 10K. There's 10K. So my pitch is actually going to take me to the east. That's going to be W. And I'm just going to start my pitch program here. We've got plenty of fuel in the main liquid fuel booster stages right now, so I'm going to take my time with this. I don't want to be rotating in any way, shape, or form whenever I decouple them. And I am just going to burn at an angle. Got that 3.0 thrust weight accelerating at 29 meters per second now, which is a good rate of acceleration for the pitch program. And I am going to continue this climb until I get to 50K apoaps. Let's see what we've got here. Where are you going to dock for fuel? Oh, that probably wasn't autocorrect. That was probably just fat finger it. Now I've got a 50K APWAP, so I'm going to turn and burn towards the horizon. Main liquid fuel boosters are now out. Let's go ahead and just throttle off. We've got time for this. Let's decouple. We've got a clean separation.